better, so we can be challenged each other and support each other. So I want to give you guys. John's from Norwood, so we always had this sort of simpatico. You know, we didn't know each other as kids, but you know, they're both sort of blue collar, lunch pail places. You know, and John's 57, I'm 54. That time was a baby boom generation, so there were kids everywhere. Everyone had older brothers that were scary. There was no leash laws. Dog ran amok, unneutered, back in the place. Nobody cared about bullying. There's no anti-bullying program. Bullying was good. They thought it made it better. Yeah. So John came in here 7 years ago, and he's got the most wonderful wife. If you guys are lucky enough to know Marilyn, you know just how wonderful she is. Sweetest person, but she's also very wise. And she came in and she said, I'm going to buy my fiance, we weren't even married at the time, some training gear. And she bought me years worth of training, which is really a wonderful thing. Everyone should do that. The smart ones do. They know how important it is for you guys. So, I was thinking about when he first came in. Actually, when John came in, he was a little guarded. And it makes sense. You know, I didn't know John for many years. And, you know, we did some powerlifting together. I always knew John was a strong guy. But when he came in, he was a little guarded. I think he was protective of Maryland. He's like, what did these guys sell her? You know? He's a little skeptical. But it makes sense when I mentioned how he grew up. You know, it was okay to be strong, but you know, you needed to be guarded too, just to protect yourself. And I'm trying to think about how different you are now. It's only 7 years. Yeah, like he's different. You know, he's mastered Jiu Jitsu, he's done a lot of different things, but I finally put my finger on it. Last night, and you're vulnerable. So, you know, my classics background, I have to explain words, I have to parse out the words, out of the etymology of words. Vulnerable means the ability to be wounded, you know? So, John was always strong, but the strength you had to have back in the day was you had to have a shield up too. You couldn't put your shield in. He couldn't be vulnerable. And John learned somehow over the last 7 years to put a shield down.
If I may join it, because when I came in vulnerable, for sure, and every one of these guys could have had their way with me, but was only interested in seeing me be a little bit better today, be a little bit better tomorrow than I was today. So it's the trust that all these guys gave me that was able for me to grow, came from them.
What I realize as well is that's true strength. That's a complete strength when you can be strong, but you can be vulnerable too. And that's the only way to develop and grow is to be vulnerable. And I think of you and the values you have as a community, and you represent them so well. We value hard work. Anybody that knows John, he works hard in the gym. He works hard in his profession for sure. We value having a growth mindset. He started a martial art in his 50s. So you know, I'm gonna figure a new martial art to start myself. I mean, that's just the epitome we're talking about. But you're also kind and inclusive. You know, that's a value that you have. You want to include everyone, give them a chance. And I think I've only had one guy that we had to leave the academy, leave our community, because he was unsavable. But you know, we try to have our doors open to everybody. And John, if you notice, he's an ambassador to the place. I don't know, some of you guys may have been on the receiving end of it. The first time in the gym, I'm usually in my office. John's out there greeting them, shaking their hand, and welcoming them and making them feel at home to be here. So, you know, that's just amazing, and I appreciate that so much.
Thank you so much.
He challenges himself. That's another value that we have. So John's competed in a couple different tournaments, and he stepped up, and he's really challenged himself. So I think when you combine that kind of strength, that sort of vulnerability, the willingness to challenge yourself, all of that creates a really nobility. You know, when I look at you, I can see you with a helmet and a shield and a sword getting ready for battle. I can completely picture that. And it's great to challenge yourself. You know, we had a guy sitting in the cage last night. You know, I often hear people say, well, as long as you step in the arena, that's all that counts. And over the years, I've come to think that isn't what counts. What counts is preparing yourself the right way, and then going in there and fighting and competing the right way. That's what counts. Anybody can just get in there, check off their bucket list. And that's what John has done in competing. His jiu-jitsu, he's prepared properly, and he went out there and he fought with the right fighting spirit. So when you do that, whatever the outcome will be, it'll be, but that's the way you want to do things. And you're a great example of that.
Thank you.
And I was thinking, if in some form or life, I was standing here with my helmet on, and my shield, and my sword, and I looked over and I saw you, I would know that you prepared right, and I know that you were going to fight, and I know I would be okay, whatever that was.
Just the same, we get through everything.
Yeah. You know, it's kind of a sad day today for me. I'll tell John. So cousin Tom, my cousin, he passed away last night.
Good guy. Good guy. Grew up in him.
And Tom was a student here. Probably none of you guys know him. You might not have had to train with him. You were probably his main training partner.
Yeah.
They would have these wars, kickboxing class. You were Tom's nemesis, I think.
But self-perceived. But you gave a good challenge.
Definitely. So, you know, I want to say something here. I don't want to overstep because John's such a modest guy. But, you know, he's preparing right, and he's fighting right. The biggest challenge that we all have to face someday, our own mortality. You know, it's one thing to go into a jiu-jitsu match, an MMA match, that seems challenging. But when you're challenged by your own mortality, that's the ultimate challenge. And what I see is I see him preparing right, and I see him fighting right. And to me, it's the highest expression of strength in all the values. So
we need it coming up.
So it's an honor for me to call you a friend and an honor to have you here in the community. Congratulations.